I want to share with you how we increased profit by $265,000 in just 30 days for one of our new clients by simply focusing on the Amazon PPC fundamentals. And after auditing more than 500 Amazon PPC accounts, I truly believe that most Amazon sellers are failing at the basics of Amazon PPC. So my goal with this presentation is to share with you 7 action steps to master the fundamentals of Amazon PPC. And to apply these 7 action steps in your Amazon PPC accounts, I'm going to share with you at the end of the presentation a clear SOPs and tools and processes to apply these 7 action steps in your Amazon PPC account. And before starting, who am I? I'm Stefano Pretto. I'm the CEO at Nomadz. We manage over $56 million in Amazon ad spend on a yearly basis for our clients. We've been working with more than 200 brands over the past years, and we have a team of more than 50 team members all over the world. To start this conversation, I want to share with you what were the mistakes I was doing when I started this journey as an Amazon PPC manager for my first client, which was a big supplements brand. It was one of the biggest supplements brands in Europe. And the mistakes I was doing back then are the same mistake I see Amazon sellers doing right now. The first one was for sure to overcomplicate processes. I was doing too many things, I was testing too many stuff, and in the end, I didn't know exactly what I wanted to achieve. That was the first mistake I was doing. So I was working too much, but I didn't get many results on this. The second one, I had this paralysis by analysis. I was watching so many YouTube videos, I was reading so many LinkedIn posts, and I didn't know exactly what to apply from these videos, and because they had so many tips and strategies, but I didn't know what were the action steps. And that is what I want to give you in this video. And finally, I was missing the key goals of Amazon PPC. What are we trying to achieve with PPC? What is the end goal of PPC? I came to the conclusion that most people tend to overcomplicate Amazon PPC. And at the beginning, I was that person. So I was overcomplicating Amazon PPC. And for me, everything changed after meeting my future business partner, Lukasz Kwiatkowski. He started Nomadz 8 years ago. And together we built our 3-step proven process to manage, optimize, and scale any Amazon PPC accounts. And in this presentation, I will focus on the organize and optimize phase. So this 3-step process is something that we always do across all our clients' accounts. But in this presentation, I want to focus on the organize and optimize phase. And I will share with you how crazy it is that with only these 2 steps, apply in your Amazon PPC account and you can achieve incredible results. This is what we did for one of our last clients, where we started working with them at the end of August. And at the end of August, they were doing roughly $400,000 in monthly profit. And after 30 days of working together, by just organizing and optimizing the account, which means to set up the strong fundamentals of Amazon PPC, we were able to increase the profitability by $265,000 a month, and we were also able to improve the sales. Not that much, but profit was insane. And now we see that the profit is consistently at $700,000 a month, which is insane, like by just doing the basics of Amazon PPC. And to start, let me define what are the goals of Amazon PPC. The main goals of Amazon PPC are to improve organic ranking and get profitable ad sales. Everything else is noise. Especially if you are doing less than $500,000 a month in total sales on Amazon, do not worry about brand awareness, do not worry about Amazon Marketing Cloud. Most likely, you just need to focus on these 2 main goals. Improve organic ranking, get profitable ad sales. If PPC is not able to help you to achieve these 2 goals, it means that you have a problem with product market fit, or you have a problem on the listing, which is still product market fit. But do not focus on anything else if you're not achieving these 2 main goals. Improve organic rank, get profitable ad sales. And remember this because we will come back during our presentation. So the first step when we start to manage any Amazon PPC accounts is to organize the account. And this phase is divided in 3 main action steps. We do an advanced audit of the account, we organize the advertising console, we do a product market and keyword analysis. And when we do this phase in new clients accounts, we see these common mistakes. We see multiple match types inside an ad group, multiple ad groups inside a campaign, inconsistent naming system, and lack of clear KPIs. Let's attack the first 2 problems. Clear structure. I'm sure you've seen many videos about this, but I see this problem so many times. we don't want to have the campaign structure on the left, we want to have the campaign structure on the right. The campaign structure on the left doesn't allow us to have a clear control and a full control over our Amazon PPC ad spend. And that is what we found inside this account. They were using a software that is using multiple ad groups inside the campaign and multiple keywords. Too many keywords inside an ad group. And so what we did, we moved from the campaign structure on the left to the campaign structure on the right. Because when you control Amazon ad spend, you are able to optimize the Amazon ad spend and you're able to scale this Amazon ad spend. So by segmenting better the campaign, we were able to control the ad spend and to spend only on what we know that is working very well. So if you have the campaign structure on the left, try to move to the campaign structure on the right as soon as possible, because that will allow you also to improve placements, optimization, to have better data in terms of top of search impression share and many other metrics. After you've done that, you want to have an effective naming system. In this account, everything was disorganized. We want to have an effective naming system. We want to quickly understand what are we doing for inside each Amazon PPC campaign. So I'm going to share with you in our blueprint, our campaign structure, so you can apply that campaign structure in your Amazon PPC account. After that, we set up some clear KPIs. For each parenthesis, and for this we use scale insights, we want to set up some clear target in terms of echoes and takeoffs. So for each parenthesis, we want to know what are we aiming for. Because if you're working with an agency, or if you have a team member in-house, or if you're managing your PPC yourself, you need to know what you're aiming for. Are you aiming for a 10% ACOS, or are you aiming for a 25% ACOS? What are your goals? You need to define these numbers, and you need to give to your team members these numbers. Because if they don't have a numbers to achieve, they will not be able to achieve this number, and you will not be able to define what is success. This is very important. This is what we did for this account in the first week. And finally, we want to analyze our market share. In this account, we were not tracking, we had one of the best sellers in a niche, and we were not tracking the market share for the main keyword. And that is a big mistake we see Amazon seller doing, because here, what we want to know, we want to understand what is the piece of our pie, like how much of our revenue is coming from this keyword, and what is our market share for this keyword. For example, for one of our best keywords, the market share for the past 6 months was around 10%, and we were able to increase the market share for that keyword up to 20% by simply pushing more for that keyword with sponsored product. So for our best keyword, we must analyze our market share every month. I spoke with a seller who is doing almost 10 million a year, and they are doing this analysis on a weekly basis with their team in-house. So we highly suggest to do this analysis. We are going to share with you the file you can use in your account to do this analysis and an SOPs on how to implement that. The organized phase consists in these four action steps: upgrade your campaign structure, improve your campaign name, set up some clear ACOS and takeoffs target on a parenthesis level, and finally analyze your market share. Only after you've done these four action steps, you can move to optimize phase. Do not start the optimize phase, do not start to create your campaigns if you didn't do these action steps first. So now we can move to the optimize phase. The optimize phase has three main subtasks, which are foundational campaigns, bidding and placement optimization, SOPs and processes. And the common mistakes when we do this phase in each account are a lack of strategy, not optimizing placements, and no clear processes. When I say lack of strategy, is connected to our goal of Amazon PPC, which is we don't know what are we trying to achieve with PPC. Sometimes we see that we are running sponsored display, we are running too much sponsored display, we are running too much sponsored brand, or we are even running DSP, even if it doesn't make sense for us. So what we want to do instead, we want to focus on what we call the foundational campaign. These are the campaigns we always create in all our clients' account when we start working with them, as soon as we finish the organized phase, because we want to make sure that we have some strong foundation for our Amazon PPC campaigns. So for each parenthesis, we want to have these five campaigns: sponsored product exact, sponsored product phrase match, sponsored product targeting campaign, sponsored brand video exact, sponsored brand video phrase. And these campaigns will follow the structure that I described at the beginning. So the campaign structure, one campaign, one ad group, 30 keyword or less. We want to have an effective naming system. We want to understand what is the target echoes we are achieving for these campaigns. And we also want to use the most relevant keyword for our products. So for each Parenthesis, we highly suggest to use this campaign structure to make sure that you are at least doing the basics of Amazon PPC. And you will not believe me how many sellers are missing these campaigns in their accounts and are not targeting relevant keyword for their products, which is insane. So that is for one thing. And for your sponsored product campaign, what you want to do placements optimization. It's something that we always see when we analyze an account that people are missing to do in the account. They are not doing this optimization. So for example, in this account, we have seen that we spent $60,000 on product page placements with a 47% ACOS, while top of search was performing with a 10% ACOS and we spent half of that amount. So for the top spending campaigns, but overall for all our campaigns, we want to optimize placements. To do that, I'm going to share with you a placement optimization tool in our blueprint that you can implement in your Amazon account. But this is key if you want to keep improving the efficiency and scale your Amazon PPC campaigns. Because segmenting the campaigns on a placement level, that is the end goal, especially if you start spending quite a lot on Amazon PPC. So highly suggest to do this because most Amazon sellers are not doing that. And finally, we want to apply a daily check-in process in our Amazon PPC accounts. The goal of an Amazon PPC agency or an Amazon PPC manager is to find problem, fix problem, find opportunities, double down on these opportunities. I said this phrase to my team so many times, but that is the job of the Amazon PPC manager, is to find problems, fix the problem, find opportunities, double down on these opportunities. And to do that, we apply what we call the daily check-in system, where we analyze and optimize the top spending campaigns. We analyze and optimize campaigns with no orders, analyze and optimize high spending campaigns with high ACOS, and analyze and optimize new campaigns. If you do these four steps on a daily basis, or if you tell your team to do these four steps on a daily basis, you will be able to understand deeply what's happening in your Amazon PPC console. Because most of the time, people don't know what's happening in their Amazon PPC console, which is scary because we are spending money and we want to make sure we are maximizing this money. So if you apply this system in your Amazon brand, I'm sure that if you have the right person managing your Amazon PPC, they will be able to find problem, fix the problem, find opportunities, double down on this. Like what we just did for the placements. If they analyze just the top spending campaigns, they will be able to see if there is a problem with placements. And if they do that on a daily basis, trust me, they will see the problem, they will fix the problem, especially if you give them the tool that I'm sharing with you today. So these are the 7 action steps I would suggest you to implement if you want to have strong fundamentals of Amazon PPC. So the first one is upgrade your campaign structure, change your campaign naming, set up some clear ACOS and ACOS target on a parenthesis level, analyze your market share, set up some your foundational campaigns and optimize placements, and finally apply the daily check-in process. Now you have all the tools, all the action steps to apply these 7 action steps in your Amazon PPC accounts. So now it's just a matter of execution. Like, you can watch all the videos you want about Amazon PPC, and that is something that I learned myself in the worst way, because I was watching so many videos and I wasn't doing anything. But this video is what I hoped I saw in the past when I just started in the Amazon PPC game. And if you apply these 7 action steps, I truly believe that your account can drastically improve. And what the case study I showed you before is just an example, but we are working with so many brands and we've seen that working so many times. So I highly suggest to take these action steps to help you to implement these 7 action steps in your Amazon PPC account. Please email me at stefano@nomadz.com and I will be more than happy to share with you this blueprint with all the tools and information to apply the 7 action steps in your Amazon PPC account. So I really hope that this video was a bit useful. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and I see you in the next one.